Hey guys, Matt here for Science or Fiction. Flying to far-off destinations and exploring a new city is great, except for the jet lag you inevitably get after you land. But hey, that's just flying, right? I mean, it's not like you could just magically make a plane that gets rid of all the physical effects of traveling through the sky at around 35,000 feet for several hours. I mean, that's just some crazy fantasy that we'll never experience in our lifetimes. It says that right there, doesn't it? Yeah, I thought so. If you've ever been on a long flight across multiple time zones, you've probably experienced the unfortunate symptoms of jet lag. Now, simply put, jet lag is a temporary sleep disorder that typically occurs when you cross two or more time zones. And there's a pretty easy explanation as to why it happens. When you take off from one time zone and land in another, your body's circadian rhythms can't just magically adapt, because your body still thinks you're in the time zone from which you left. Now, this can leave you feeling irritable, tired, it can even cause stomach problems. Fortunately, it's temporary. It varies from person to person how long it lasts, but typically it takes a day per time zone crossed before your body can adapt to the new rhythm. But if you're going on a shorter trip, that can put a major kink in your travel plans. I mean, who wants to get all the way to Bergen and be too tired to explore the exciting second largest city in Norway? Don't you want to see this bird? How about this rack of sweaters? Now, despite what this article seems to say, there is no total cure for jet lag. Some things just require time, guys. But Boeing has designed a plane that can minimize its symptoms by using air pressure and increased humidity. Most planes are currently pressurized to simulate the conditions a person would feel at 6,000 to 8,000 feet, which isn't too bad considering that most planes fly between 30,000 and 40,000 feet. But 8,000 feet is still a pretty high altitude that can lead to symptoms like headache and nausea, similar to what's called altitude sickness. Now, the Boeing 787 Dreamliner family of airplanes is pressurized to a new maximum level of 6,000 feet, 2,000 feet lower than most other aircraft. Altitude chamber tests from Boeing show that because the body absorbs 8% more oxygen into the blood at this altitude, passengers experience fewer headaches and less dizziness and fatigue. That lower cabin pressurization is possible due to the increased use of composites. These new airplanes are 50% composite by weight. Carbon fiber reinforced polymer, also known as CFRP, resists fatigue and corrosion more than traditional metals used to build planes and therefore allows for more internal pressurization. CFRP also means that planes can withstand more humidity. Metal can corrode when exposed to humid air, but that's not as much of an issue with the new material. Now, that matters to you because while you might not notice a change in humidity at the moment, you likely will notice that your throat, eyes, and nose are less dry when you land. Now, again, these engineering changes don't cure jet lag, but the lower cabin pressurization and increased humidity will make you feel more comfortable during your flight to Bergen. That being said, I'd sleep on the plane if you can. Unfortunately, there's still no cure for jumping time zones. For more epic stories of innovation that shaped our future, check out theageofaerospace.com. Can you get jet lag flying on a helicopter? And I guess it wouldn't be jet lag, right? It'd be like helicopter lag. Well, I know you would get a killer headache because helicopters are super loud, but did you know there's such a thing as a stealth helicopter? Yeah, it's a thing. Check it out here. And as always, please be sure to subscribe and make sure to keep coming back to Seeker for more videos.